Okay, so today I'm going to tell you how to get a job in the television business. I'll tell you how I got a job in the television business, and maybe you'll take a lesson from that. It's a weird business, but it's a weird story, so it's kind of a good fit. I didn't start off wanting to work in the television business. I didn't study journalism in school. I wasn't some junior reporter running around for the school newspaper. I had no interest in it whatsoever. In fact, I was a graduate student in Islamic studies. Maybe I should have stuck with that. I can still bismillah to the best. But I needed money. As a graduate student, you don't get a lot of money, and I needed money. So I went to this temp agency called Career Blazers. They blaze your way to a career as a temp in offices answering phones or doing alphabetical filing. And because I had studied with Miss Chaffee in junior high school, touch typing, I could actually type 60 words a minute pretty much without a mistake. And so Career Blazers sent me off to these typing jobs. This is before there was word processing. You'd come in, you get a pile of tapes, you'd put on headphones, and you'd sit and you'd type transcripts for $5 an hour. Law firms that did depositions were big on this, banks, insurance companies, and that's where I was going. Every day I'd go off to some insurance company or some law firm and get my typing job and sit there for 5 or 6 hours typing. Anyway, one day they sent me to a TV studio. I didn't think about television, but you know, TV does all these interviews and they used to tape record them. It was the same job. So I'm sitting there typing my thing, and on the second or third or fourth day that I'm there, suddenly all hell breaks loose in the newsroom. Everybody's screaming and yelling. I didn't know what was going on. I was screaming and yelling, and phones are ringing, and I turned to the guy next to me and said, "What happened?" And he said, "The Iranians just seized our embassy in Tehran." Well, it's not my problem. I don't live in Tehran. Now. So I kept typing away, and the executive producer of the show, a guy named George Merlis, comes running into the newsroom like General Patton. These guys love this stuff. And he starts saying, "You call the White House, and you call the Pentagon, and you call..." Everybody's getting a job. And he pointed at me. He didn't know who I was. And he says, "You call the Islamic Center in Washington, D.C. Well, all right, you know, you're paying me $5 an hour. I'll do whatever you want. So I took off the headphones, and I dialed up the phone, and I went, "Salam alaikum, ya sadiq, ana min al good morning America." And suddenly this guy Merlis grabs me like this, and he goes, "You speak Arabic." And I went, "Yeah, I didn't speak Arabic." He goes, "Where did you learn?" Just to mess around with them, I said, "When I lived in Iran." Well, I'd been to Iran, but they don't speak Arabic in Iran. They speak Farsi, but this is television news. Nobody knew anything anyway. So he goes, "You lived in Iran?" And yeah, I'd been in Iran, I'd been alive. So I lived in Iran. I said, "Yes." And he said, "Do you know anything about these hostages?" Well, I said, "Yes," because the guy next to me told me the hostages were just taken. So I know something. So I said, "Yes." So he turns to me and says, "Get this guy a desk and a typewriter." I already had a desk and a typewriter. And I was hired on the spot as the Middle East expert for Good Morning America. A fantastic job, considering I was looking at making, you know, $12,000 a year teaching Arabic at Kentucky State Teachers College. Suddenly I'm surrounded by these people who make a lot of money in the television business, and I am the Middle East expert. So immediately we all got up and we went in this big conference room down the hall, and everybody was there. Peter Jennings, who was the anchor, and of course I sat in the back, I didn't say very much. And the vice president of news came in, and she pulls down the map of the world, and literally, it's a true story, she spent 10 minutes looking for Iran, because none of these people knew a goddamn thing. But of course, that didn't stop them from getting on the air, you know, an hour later, doing some live, ABC News special on Iran, this kind of crap. They didn't know anything. And the whole time I was there, they didn't know anything. And my job, I used to go sit with David Hartman, who was the anchor, you know, the Matt Lauer, or whoever it is now. And the guy he'd been a TV doctor on a TV show called Lucas Tanner MD before that. He didn't know a thing either. And I used to sit and explain to him, you know, we get a live satellite interview with Sadegh Qutbzadeh, the new president of Iran. And he'd go, "Is he a good guy or is he a bad guy?" The dumbest of the dumb. The dumbest of the dumb people were giving their news and informing America. I didn't know a damn thing. And I think to this day, they still don't know very much. But that's the television news business. If you want to work in it, be my guest. Yeah, that's it. So go get yourself a video camera and make your own stuff. Forget about networks. It's a waste of time.